Hello, statistics students. In a previous series called SPSS for Beginners, I introduced you to IBM SPSS Statistics. Now, I assume that you were brand new to SPSS, so I taught you the basics, gave you a quick start to get comfortable with using the software. But now it's time to move beyond the basics. You are already familiar with SPSS, so now it's time to go a little deeper into tricks that will sharpen your SPSS skills, give you more confidence, and impress your classmates. And who knows, maybe even your instructor. Essentially, I made this to be the video series that I wish that I had when I started using SPSS. So come along as we dive deeper into SPSS. Are you ready to move beyond the basics? Whether you are still new to SPSS or you have been using it for years, I think that you will learn some new tricks. And if you are new to SPSS, these are tricks that will make it feel like you have been using SPSS for years. So first, we are going to dive into greater depth on how to customize SPSS settings. I've already shown you how to get your data into SPSS from Excel. Now I'm going to show you how to get data into SPSS from other common sources, like a text file. Plus, I will teach you some special settings that can clean up the messy data when you import. I'm going to introduce you to rectangular data so that you will understand how to structure your data collection spreadsheet if you plan to use SPSS. We're going to dive deeper into central tendency, variability, and graphing, and you will learn exactly how to select the correct measurement for any level of data. Then we are going to dive deeper into tables and charts, including how to get your charts closer to APA style in SPSS. We will learn about SPSS syntax. Now, you may think that you do not know how to write computer code, but you can, and in fact, you already do. Now, these are the tricks that will save you loads of time and move you closer to being a power user. Finally, we're going to learn how to send output to other applications, such as Microsoft Word, Excel, PDF, or even HTML. You are going to become an SPSS pro, no matter whether you're taking an introductory statistics class or working on your dissertation. You will know SPSS tricks that will save you time and frustration. Thanks for going along with me on this trip. So let's dive a little deeper into SPSS.